Chapter number 2, Structure of Indian Penal Code. Indian Penal Code is basically a substantive law. Substantive law is a law which defines the law. So in Indian Penal Code, crimes are defined and punishment for that crime is also defined. Procedural law for IPC is CRPC. IPC is a substantive law. Next thing, IPC defines crime and defines punishment for those crimes. So that is there in IPC. In IPC, there are 23 chapters and 511 sections. It is broadly divided into crimes against body, crimes against property. So crimes against human body, they are there in IPC. Crimes against property, crimes against public tranquility. Public tranquility means public peace and order. Okay, so unlawful assembly and that type of crimes. Crimes against state, waging a war against state and that those type of offenses. So offenses against states or crimes against state, and then there are general exceptions in which cases exceptions are available for that crime. So this is a structure of Indian Penal Code in short. Objective questions can be asked on this, like how many chapters are there? 23 chapters are there. How many sections are there? 511 sections are there in IPC. So this is about the structure of Indian Penal Code. Some important points to remember about Indian Penal Code for CLAT and for UPSC students. It was drafted by whom? It was drafted by First Law Commission under the chairmanship of Lord Macaulay. Okay. Second, why IPC is made? IPC is a public law and it is made to maintain peace and order in society. Third, what is there in Indian Penal Code? Definition of offense and punishment for that offense is there in Indian Penal Code. Number four, whether IPC is a substantive law or procedural law. IPC is a substantive law which defines crime, okay? But it doesn't provide for a procedure. What is a procedure for IPC? How to catch a person? How to punish that person? What should happen in a court? So that procedure is there in procedural law. But IPC is substantive law and not a procedural law, okay? Why it is called as a penal law? Indian Penal Code, what is the meaning of this? Penal law means which penalizes. Penalizes means which punishes. And so IPC is all about crime and punishment for crime. So it is a penal law. Penal law means which law, a law which provides for punishment or which punishes. Okay. Then how many sections are there in IPC? There are 511 sections in IPC. And how many chapters are there in IPC? There are 23 chapters in IPC. So these are the general questions which can be asked for CLAT and for UPSC. That's it for the day. Stay tuned till my next lecture. Goodbye and good luck.